We all know politicians lie, but Anthony Albanese is taking it to a global level. Now, one of the weird things about the coronation is an opportunity for us little people to be able to shout back our allegiance to the monarch. Now, I'm not really a Republican or a monarchist. I just find this particular moment weird. But Anthony Albanese has given an interview to our mate Piers Morgan where he says he will swear allegiance to the King.
I think you can be a lifelong Republican, which I am, and still respect our institutions. And certainly I have a great deal of respect for King Charles. And it's a great honour to be here representing Australia. All Australians wish King Charles well, regardless of the different views that people will have about our constitutional arrangements.
Clearly he'll have a hand behind his back with his fingers crossed while he's giving the oath, because remember, this is a Prime Minister that already has a full-time Minister for the Republic, and the expectation is that if, most likely, re-elected in 2025, by 2026, Australia will be beginning the process of becoming a republic. Now, do I suggest that Anthony Albanese should stand there and boo at the coronation? No. But what exactly is the point of pledging allegiance to a person who it is your avowed political position to remove from any relevancy in Australia? No wonder I call him Each Way Albo. And for some reason, people will be completely fine with this. And yes, I know the oath is not legally binding and no one will be coming for the Prime Minister of Australia should he break the oath. But when he doesn't believe it, why is he saying it at all? And why are we okay with him saying it at all?